Hey everyone, welcome to the video. As you know from the title, today we'll be doing a video masking tutorial. And I actually drew inspiration for this tutorial from this particular webpage. I've been looking at the Cyberpunk 2077 landing page the other day, and I thought what they did here is a really cool example of how you could integrate videos into landing pages without it actually throwing people off, but adding to the design and adding to the story that the landing page wants to tell. The design of the page overall is also really cool, and if you guys would be interested to know how to make this kind of buttons or these section separators, just let us know in the comments and we'll see if we could possibly make a long video trying to recreate some of the tricks they pulled off with this design. Well, you'd probably like to see it if you are a Cyberpunk aesthetic fan. But what I did for this tutorial is I tried to very roughly recreate the hero section. So this is the video and this is the mask that I have created. This was not meant to completely replicate the original design, but rather to give you some context for what we'll be doing today. And we'll also have a look at some other examples of how you could mask your videos. And the process itself is actually very, very simple. But as you know, on this channel, we often pick up some cool ideas and try and show you how you could recreate it using Elementor Page Builder, often only the free version. Very often the free version is just enough to make some really cool stuff. And by using this method I'm about to show you, you can create all sorts of masks. And what's great about it is that you do not need any additional software. You do not need to apply a mask directly on a video and then render it out with the mask on top of it using some video editing software. This is not what we're going to be doing. What we'll be doing is using a free and super intuitive and simple to use tool called Figma. It is web-based, it is completely free, and everything that we're going to be doing in this video will be accomplished thanks to this free tool and then simply dropped into the Elementor video library and applied on top of a video. And I'm going to show you the entire process step by step, starting with this particular design. This is what we're going to start with. I'll show you how you can apply this mask on top of a video so it all looks organic and blends with the background. Another advantage of this method is that it's still going to work on a mobile device. Even though you do not always have enough space to put a video on the mobile version of your page, but there is still such an option, and I'm going to show you how to do that too. So let's start fresh here in Figma. What we're about to do is create a new shape, and you're just going to grab the rectangle or just press R and draw any random shape. It does not matter the dimensions just yet because we're going to change them right now. Over here, go to the design panel on your right and type in the parameters for the width and the height of the shape, and it should match the dimensions of your video. It is not so crucial for it to be the exact same number of pixels for the width and for the height, but it is important that this particular shape that you are drawing right now matches the dimensions of your video. If it is 1:1, then it would be like this. But if it's 16:9, then it will be like this. Now, just leave it there. You can lock it if you feel more comfortable doing that. And we're going to start drawing the mask. I'm going to use the pen tool. It is either P on the keyboard, and it is very convenient that they're actually showing you the shortcuts for every single tool that you have in your toolbar. And I'm going to create a simple shape over here. And I'm just going to proceed to draw something that resembles the original shape from the game website. And I'm creating the 45 degree angle with this line by simply pressing shift. This is going to give you a perfect angle if this is what you're looking for. Don't make it perfect on the outside, just make sure that the inside shape that you're drawing matches the design that you're going for. That it is rather perfect on the inside and not on the outside. Now we're going to finish up the shape by drawing a rectangle, holding shift and rotating it until it's about 45 degrees, and I'm going to place it over there. Now, Now we only have a stroke on these shapes, I just noticed that. And to change it, we're gonna hold shift and press X here as well. It is going to switch from stroke to fill, and now all of our shapes are filled. I'm going to group these by pressing Ctrl G. And here on the right in the design panel in the selection colors, I'm gonna paste the colors of my shape. Now as this part is done, unlock the rectangle so we can select it, and let's mask this pattern that we just drew. And we need the rectangle, which is going to be the mask, to be underneath our pattern. Now we're going to select both of these and simply click use as mask. What it is going to do is simply clip the pattern to the shape of the rectangle. This is exactly what we need. We're gonna click on the parent group, make sure it is selected, go to export and click export mask group. And what it is going to do is allow you to download the PNG of this particular group, so you can later insert it in Elementor. We're downloading PNG because PNG is the format that allows you to have a transparent background, and you do need a transparent background for this purpose. Before we click export, let's actually rename it to something more recognizable. There we are, just downloaded the shape. Now I'm back in Elementor. I'm going to quickly run you through the structure of this particular section. In this case, all it is just the inner section, and what we are about to do is only possible if you're working with sections. You cannot do the same thing with the column, and you cannot do the same thing with the video widget. We're going to do this the easiest way and the most fail-proof way. Let's see why. Now the rest of the process is as simple as just inserting the video as the background of this section. First, I'll temporarily remove the background image. Then I'll go to the settings of this section, go to style, and in the style tab, go to background and select video. It is available in all the latest versions of free Elementor Page Builder. Here, you can either place a link to a YouTube video or a Vimeo video, or just the video file hosted somewhere else, even in your media library. And here is my link. And now go to background overlay, so now we can add our mask. And this is what it's going to look like at the beginning, but it is not the result that we want. This is why we need to tweak a couple settings, like the position, attachment is fine, repeat, no repeat, and the size will be cover. And then we'll move the opacity slider up, just so this overlay is not transparent anymore. Now if we want the size of our video to match up with the size of our section, we need to tweak the size of this particular column in which this inner section is placed. We need to tweak a couple settings, because in my case it is an inner section and is placed inside of a column. I'm using margins to adjust the width of my column by moving it to the right. And to adjust the height, I'm going to use the minimum height slider in the section settings. This is how we're going to match up the size of the video with the size of the column and make sure that our overlay perfectly covers it. Now let's place our background image back here. Now this exact same process will totally work with any other kind of a mask, with any other kind of a shape that you want to put on top of your video. So that was it for today's quick tip. And if you liked the video, make sure you leave us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more Elementor tutorials. And if you have a request, make sure you leave it in the comments down below. We'll always read our comments and always reply to them. So feel free to leave your feedback and a request. Also, if you're new here, we at Template Monster not only have a YouTube channel where we try to teach and inspire you to create some cool looking stuff, but we also have a platform which is called TemplateMonster Marketplace, where you can get all sorts of digital products to boost your productivity and creative workflow. And very soon, we're having a huge update, which is going to expand the marketplace, because we're going to add a number of new product categories. So if you're interested in that, stick around. We're going to have a live stream on this channel and we're going to answer all of your questions that you guys might have about this new marketplace update. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you in the next one.